Hey guys, and welcome back to the Acne channel. My name is Lavinia Rosonda from the YouTube channel Lavinia Rosonda, where I post videos regarding makeup and skincare. And today we will be discussing professional versus at-home microneedling treatments. Recently on this channel, I did talk about the science behind microneedling, what it is, and everything you need to know. So if you haven't seen that, go check it out. It might include some important information for you to learn about before watching this video. And today we will be continuing that conversation by discussing the different methods of microneedling and the comparison between at-home treatments versus the professional in-office ones. So let's get started. So I'm going to start off by talking about professional microneedling treatments. Now, there are a few options when it comes to this. And of course, such treatments should only be done by certified professionals such as dermatologists and estheticians. You should not be trying to conclude these treatments on your own. One of the methods we will be discussing today is the vampire facial / PRP microneedling. If you don't know what this is, you've probably seen pictures on social media of people who have blood on their face during a facial, and that is why it's called the vampire facial sometimes. And this treatment is a combination of microneedling and PRP, which is platelet-rich plasma. And if you don't know what PRP is, it is the serum contained within the blood that has powerful platelets and are used to help growth factors within the skin to help stimulate cell turnover and overall make the skin look younger and smoother. So basically within this treatment, the patient's own blood is used to promote collagen production and skin cell activity. So to start off this treatment, the blood is usually drawn from the patient's arm and run through a centrifuge, which will basically spin the blood in order to separate it into blood and the platelets. So therefore you will see the blood still in its red color and then the PRP in a yellow color. After this is done, a numbing cream is usually applied all over the patient's face and the microneedling can now take place where they will be injecting that PRP back into the patient's skin using the microneedling technique. By using these needles, micro tears are created in the skin, allowing the PRP to be injected deeper within the epidermis. After this, the PRP is spread all over the face with radio frequency. And really, the overall goal of this treatment is to improve collagen production, elastin, and antioxidant properties. So after this is done, of course, it is more of an invasive treatment. So usually 1 to 2 days is needed for recovery, but the recovery also depends on how sensitive your skin is normally without this treatment being done and with the type of needles used, so that can really extend or shorten the recovery time. Overall, this is a pretty low risk treatment, with one of the only risks being bruising happening in the location that the blood is drawn, like the arm. While you are in the recovery phase, you do want to stay out of the sun since your skin is definitely compromised. Your skin may even look red or irritated, and you may have some skin shedding 3 to 4 days after the treatment is done. Within this time, you do not want to be using any makeup or skincare on your skin as it is definitely exposed, so just stick to using water to rinse off. So, is this treatment right for you? So as long as you don't have a history of blood disease or blood clots, you should be perfectly fine to do this treatment, but of course talk to your dermatologist or esthetician. And overall, this treatment is best for someone who is trying to minimize scars, hyperpigmentation, and dark spots, as we will have that collagen production occur after this treatment is done. If you want to know more about that, again, reference back to the science behind microneedling video. As far as the cost of this treatment, it does range around $1,000 per treatment. This price can vary depending on the office and the dermatologist you are seeing. And usually what I've seen is around 3 treatments needing to be done. So of course your overall cost will depend on how many treatments you do and who you are seeing to do it. But typically multiple treatments are recommended to see the best result. So now let's move on to cosmetic / at-home microneedling, the different methods and what it's all about. There are a few types. There is the pen type, which just like a regular pen, the needles come in and out of the actual device. Then we do have the roller method. This is just a roller with a bunch of tiny little needles on it. And then we also have the stamp device right here. This is the Banisher 2.0. So overall with these at-home treatments, they do not penetrate the skin as deeply, which of course makes it easier to use and easier for you to conduct safely at home. They can also be used to not only help with scarring and hyperpigmentation, but also product absorption and exfoliation. Now with this and the needles being not as long and not penetrating as deeply into the skin, you will see slower results. So therefore with these at-home treatments, you do need need to use them consecutively over a longer period of time to really see a change in your skin. But as I said, if used consistently, you definitely can see results from these at-home treatments. With the Banisher 2.0 specifically, this one features 24K gold-plated titanium bristles, which is great since it's better at resisting bacteria. And Banish also does offer a 30-day guarantee. With something like this, results are typically seen within 2 to 3 months of using it consistently. I typically would use this once a week since I have super sensitive skin and I don't want to overdo it on my skin. But doing it consistently for a long period of time, you can definitely see results within your hyperpigmentation, scarring, or whatever you're trying to treat through the microneedling process. As again, we will have that collagen production and skin regeneration using a product like this. So now, what are the risks with these at-home methods? Obviously, the biggest risk is someone not using these products correctly. Of course, you want to be following all manufacturer instructions, making sure that you're doing every step correctly, and not using such device too often. Listen to your skin. If your skin feels too sensitive, don't overdo it. Don't go in with other exfoliators or physical or chemical after using this. You know, make sure you're wearing your sunscreen, all of that. Follow the instructions as they are set. And the other thing is making sure that you're sanitizing and not actually risking the spread of bacteria or infection over your skin by using one of these. So step number one, you want to soak the product in 70% alcohol for 5 minutes. This one even comes with a little cap that you can do so in. You want to do this before your treatment and then just let it air dry for around 5 minutes. Once this is sanitized, you obviously want to also get your skin clean. So make sure you cleanse your skin with not too stripping of a cleanser, of course. After that, you can use the tool and press it on the area you are trying to treat 4 to 5 times, rotating 90 degrees between each press. This way you are making sure you are getting the full area covered and treated. It is overall pretty quick and easy of a process. Afterwards, you can apply a vitamin C serum. Banish does offer their vitamin C serum, which I really like and pairs really nicely with the Banisher 2.0. Just for a little explanation, vitamin C in conjunction with a microneedling treatment really helps at brightening the skin and helping with those scars, pigmentation, and what you are trying to treat. And after you're done that, you're gonna repeat sanitizing this tool. So again, fill this little cap with 70% alcohol and just screw this back on, let it sit for around 5 minutes, and then dump that alcohol out. And that way, by following those steps, you're making sure that you're sanitizing the device correctly, using it correctly, and also make sure to not use this too often. Wear sunscreen and protect your skin. So now that we've covered both professional and at-home methods, what are the key differences between them and which one is right for you? So obviously, the at-home treatments will be a lot more inexpensive. If you're not wanting to invest thousands of dollars in these treatments, an at-home treatment might be a great place to start. There's also way less downtime, and results can show within a few treatments if used consistently. And of course, it's very convenient and easy to do at home. Doesn't take a lot of training, and you don't have to worry about a lot of risk. Also, with a device like this, you can spot treat where you want. So let's say there's just one spot that you are trying to treat. You can just do that repeatedly over a few months rather than going in to get your whole face done. But of course, with these at-home treatments, it may take longer to see those results. You will see faster and more noticeable results from the in-office treatments due to the longer needles. And with the professional microneedling, PRP is also available for those added benefits. Of course, this method is more expensive. Think of it more as an investment for your skin. You would need multiple treatments to really see results. And of course, it's all over more invasive, more downtime, and more time for your skin to heal. So which method is right for you? I would say for deeper, more severe scarring, definitely go see your dermatologist and kind of discuss these in-office methods, just because sometimes an at-home treatment might not be as effective for those deep-set scars. For acne scars or some hyperpigmentation that's maybe not as severe, I would definitely check out an at-home method. You know, it's relatively inexpensive and you can just do it from the comfort of your home when you need it. I would say that's the biggest thing. Cost, the type of scarring or affected area you are trying to treat, as well as the downtime. So if you don't want to have those 1 to 2 days off where you need your skin to heal, that may be a factor you need to consider when choosing between these methods. So that's really all I had to talk about today. I hope this video was helpful for you if you were wanting to learn more about in-office versus at-home microneedling treatments. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to the Acne channel for tons more videos on acne and skincare tips. And don't forget to turn on our post notifications so you get notified every single time we upload a new video. If you want to see more of me, you can find me at Lavinia Rosando on Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube, of course. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!